welcome both of them for coming and watching this. This is an important demonstration that we applied for a grant for, and it'll show you the benefit of sprinkler systems in the home. And with that, Jeremy's going to talk about the rest of it and how we're going to do and what we do, okay?
All right, like Chief Fisher said, thanks for coming. We really appreciate the opportunity to give this demonstration. Big thanks to the the grant that we received came through the Home Fire Sprinkler Coalition. They're a nationwide not-for-profit that promotes sprinklers in the house. Looks like we're getting a little sprinkle from above here. We also had a couple of other local partners that assisted, Economy Lumber and Hardware, helped us out with a lot of the building materials, and Campbell Fire Protection out of Harrisonville. They installed fire alarms, extinguishers, and sprinkler systems. They provided all the sprinkler components and accessories that we needed for the demonstration. A little bit about the units. The units are basically the same. They're 8x8. Each have a couch, a chair, an end table. You may have seen me loading the fire sets in the back. We've got a trash basket in the back corner and a cardboard box that are stuffed with newspapers, and that's all we're using to start the fire. We're not using any kind of accelerants or fuels or anything like that. It's cardboard and newspaper. The one on the right obviously is unsprinkled. We will light it first as it's burning. We've got clock over here, and we'll kind of talk through the process of when a fire starts, to notification, to the fire department arriving, and those kinds of things. And then we'll do the same thing on the sprinkler unit. A little thing about the sprinkler, if you had a chance to look at the room before, you'll notice it's what we call a concealed head. So it's got a little plastic cap over it, so you don't see the sprinkler head coming down. A lot of people don't like to see that. You may have seen that in hotels or different things like that. And the way that works, that little cap is set at 135 degrees. It will drop and drops the little sprinkler head down. And then at 160 degrees, the sprinkler head will activate. So when that ceiling hits 160 degrees is when the water will start flowing. So, again, this is something that's very important to all of us in the fire department. We have over 3,000 deaths annually with fires. Over 80% of those occur in homes. They don't occur in businesses. They don't occur on the street. You know, they occur in people's homes and apartments. So that's why we feel this is so important. Alarm sounding. So what are you going to be doing at this time? You're going to be exiting your house. When you exit your house, you're going to call 911. Okay, so we're about 15 seconds in. You make the call to 911. 911 operator is going to get your information, your address. They're going to do what they need to do. That usually takes about 45 seconds to a minute and a half to get us dispatched.
Jeremy.
So as you can see, it's got into the couch a little bit. We're at 40 seconds. So as you can see, I heard somebody say, "How, look how black it is." One thing about the way we build homes and we furnish homes today is everything's either a plastic or a petroleum-based product. It puts off a lot of toxic gases, toxic heat, smoke, and we don't want to be breathing that, obviously. It's very harmful. Now, we're in about a minute and 23 seconds. So about this time, we're going to be getting dispatched on an average call. So the cones are just now dropping in our station from the time the fire started. We have an average response time in the city of just over 3.5 minutes. It was 3 minutes and 34 seconds last year. So if we add that to our 122, we're just about 5 minutes. So at the 5 minute point, we'll see kind of where the fire is. As you can see, our curtain in the back's already gone. It's rolling across the roof. So, as you can see now, the acrylic's coming off. We're at 2 minutes and 24 seconds. We're still 2.5 minutes from your house, okay? Right. Now we're going to go ahead and let the guys put it out just from a safety standpoint. We were still about 2 minutes from being at your house if this was your house on fire. And again, this was newspaper and a cardboard box. This is all that we lit. So a discarded cigarette in a trash can that's not properly out, a candle knocking over into a trash can, a lot of different scenarios that we can play out in there. We're going to make sure we've got it out real good. And one thing I might mention too is after we're done and we're sure that it's out, we'll bring the caution tape down and you guys can be able to get a little closer look at the extended damage. If we were in a little more open area, we probably would have let it go just a little bit longer to show. What we were approaching was a term we call flashover, where the entire contents of the room will flash. And probably within another 30 to 60 seconds of that burning, we would have actually hit flashover, which again, even with a 3.5 minute response time is before we get there. Okay, we're going to run the clock again on this one. Say we were about just under 3 minutes on the last one when we extinguished it. Okay, so the fire's lit. Smoke detector's going off 6 seconds. Again, so now hopefully you've spent about 30 seconds, you're out of the house, you're calling 911 to get us on our way. A lot of the things that we don't think about in our homes is our couches, our cushions, our drapes, TVs, computers. Like I said earlier, everything that we have in our homes is a plastic-based or petroleum-based product. There goes the sprinkler head at 56 seconds. go ahead and activate it 56 seconds after the start of the fire. Again, that sprinkler head, the cap is rated at 135. The sprinkler head itself is rated at 160, so they're going to overhaul it here real quick just to make sure. A big concern that folks have with sprinkler systems is the possibility of a leak or damage in their home. How many of you guys have running water in your house today? Pretty much all of us. If you've got the same likelihood of a leak with the sprinkler system as you do with your water system that's already running, your faucet, your shower, everything else. A lot of the concerns too are with the amount of water that the sprinkler head puts out. How many of you guys, you may have a guess how much water that sprinkler head puts out? How about 5 gallons? A little bit more than that.
10 gallons.
10 gallons. That sprinkler head will put out between 11 to 40 gallons per minute, depending on the pressure of the line feeding it. So we had 55 pounds of pressure on this line, so he was probably putting about 26 or 7 gallons per minute, which sounds like a lot of water if you have a fire in your house. Guess what one of these hoses puts out? Anybody have an idea? You got an idea? 50 gallons, a little more. Each one of our hand lines will put out 150 gallons per minute.
Go ahead and set it around back, guys.
So, when people talk about potential water damage in their house and stuff, we're going to do a lot more water damage with our hoses. I mean, for two reasons. One, we use more water. And two, about 4 or 5 minutes after the sprinkler head activates is the timeline that we're getting there. So we've got a lot bigger fire. We may have two lines. We may have three lines. So we're going to put a lot of water on it to get it knocked out. So, if anybody has any questions, we'll be around the booth. We've got all kinds of information. One thing that many of you would probably be interested about is cost. What does it cost to put a sprinkler system in your house? It varies a little bit, but it's usually between $1.50 and $2 a square foot. So if you're building a 2,000 square foot home, you're looking at about $3,500 to $4,000, kind of depending on the exact layout and how it all works out. So it's pretty economical. Now, if we're talking about retrofitting an old house like my house, you're talking a lot more dollars. And it's kind of a case by case. It's hard to give an exact number. But if you're building new, on an average home, you're looking at $3,000 to $4,000. The scenario I like to play out is it's cheaper than on probably what you're going to pay for the kitchen cabinets in your house. And it could save you paying a lot. Appreciate everybody coming today. Again, we'll get this kind of cleaned up and let you guys be able to see it here in just a few minutes. And like I said, if you have any questions, come over to our booth. We've got literature. We'd be glad to talk to you. Thanks for coming, everybody.